Consecration to the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the presence of God, Almighty Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, heaven and earth is our witness, we prostrate ourselves at thy feet, O Mary, our Lady. 100 years ago, Fatima, heard its ask that the whole human race be consecrated to thy Immaculate Heart. Today we wish to consecrate to thee our apostolate, its members, and all of those who are working for it, in order to place ourselves always under thy most benevolent and eternal protection. We acknowledge thee as our mother, as the Immaculate Conception, living tabernacle of the divinity, as Queen of angels and of men, as mother of the Church and of the Catholic priesthood, as refuge of sinners and the faithful. That is why, small and weak that we are, we wish to consecrate to thee our apostolate, our persons, our works, our future, all that pertains to us and is in us, and to which God in his immeasurable goodness has entrusted to us for our good use. We also consecrate to thee the value of our good actions, past, present, and future, leaving to thee the entire and full right of disposing of us, our institute, and all that belongs to us. Mary, be our mother. Sanctify us, purify us, correct us, guide us, pray for us, and protect us. Help us to fulfill scrupulously the duties of our state of life. Extinguish in us all self-love, which prevents thy divine Son from reigning in and around us. Cover abundantly with thy maternal protection our apostolate, and mayest thou forever impede the devil from reigning in any manner in this apostolate, which desires to be entirely thine for the greater glory of God, the exaltation of our Mother, the Catholic Church, the Holy Catholic Church, and for the conversion of sinners.
Take and be with the great now in unitate. Thank you.
Starting Ascension. The Church awaits in prayer and in faith the coming of the Holy Spirit, which will take place liturgically next Sunday, Pentecost. The coming of the Holy Spirit promised by the Lord in that gospel. It is, of course, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the Father and the Son, the Spirit of Jesus, who continues to guide and direct the Church on her way through history. The Church could not continue without the guidance and the power of the Holy Spirit. At the time of the Apostles and the foundation of the Church, we read, especially in the Acts of the Apostles, that the Holy Spirit is particularly active, inspiring and strengthening the disciples, especially when they met suffering and persecution. Think of Stephen, the first martyr. We are told in the Acts of the Apostles, Stephen was full of the Holy Spirit. St. Luke, the author of the Acts, also uses the same phrase when he speaks of Barnabas, the traveling companion of Paul. Barnabas was full of the Holy Spirit. Peter and Paul, of course, and the others were guided and strengthened and brought forward by what Christ promised them, the Holy Spirit. And indeed in John's Gospel we're told on Easter day, he breathed on them and said, receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. So we as a church are missing, again, liturgically, but in a very real way, the coming of the Holy Spirit. And traditionally, of course, we've been in Avena this time from Thursday to next Sunday, 9 days of prayer, for a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And I invite you, dear brothers and sisters, to make that Novena your own, either as a group or individually, asking the Father, in the name of his Son, to send once more upon the Church and the Word, the Holy Spirit. So let us pray for a broken heart, so that the Spirit lead us ever more deeply into the truth about Jesus as the Son of the Father, our Lord and Savior. That is the Holy Spirit's task, by the way, to deepen our knowledge, our appreciation, our awareness of who Jesus is, the one who has come from heaven to be our Savior. We can all grow in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus. One who helps that growth, makes it possible, is of course the Holy Spirit. You know, we only can love what we know, and the aim of the Christian life is to grow in the knowledge of Jesus, day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year. We grow mysteriously, but in a real way, in faith, who Jesus is and what he means for each of us, for the Church and for the world. St. Paul has a phrase, put on the mind of Christ. Now that's the work of the Holy Spirit. We can't do that ourselves. What we can do is open our hearts, be disposed to it, asking that all the thoughts and feelings that constantly trip us up may not prevent the Holy Spirit from coming to us. And even a little prayer every day this week, the well-known one, I was saying it certainly, come Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Lovely prayer, recite that, will make the difference. In our first reading, which I read there from the first letter of St. Peter, the great apostle exalts his hearers example by showing love and hospitality to one another. What a difference that can make. Little acts of love, acts of kindness, expressed in so many ways. Hospitality, welcoming others into our company, showing them the face of Christ. And you know, it is by doing the little things of every day as best we can. In point of fact, we're giving proof of the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. Because the teaching of the Church in more recent times of the Vatican Council, the Second Vatican Council, is that the Holy Spirit gives his gifts to every single member of the Church. None of you in this congregation is without at least one gift of the Holy Spirit, what St. Paul and Peter would call charisms. We hope the bishops have these charisms, your priests, but you have them yourself, dear brothers and sisters. And every gift of the Holy Spirit, be it apparently insignificant, is very important. So part of your novena in this coming week, to pray for an awareness into your own gifts that God has given you. And there are many gifts indeed, as we hear next Sunday. And do you know, I say we all have the gifts of the Holy Spirit. You might say, how do you know that, Bishop? In our baptism, we have all put on Christ. The way I'm dressed up here this morning, the way you dress up. St. Paul says that's an image or a metaphor for what takes place at our baptism. We put on Christ, and hence Christ had the fullness of the Holy Spirit, St. John tells us, but he doesn't keep it to himself. He shares it with others, and the others are you and I and his Church. Is what keeps the Church going, as I said at the beginning, in our long journey pilgrimage through history on our way to the final consummation in the kingdom of God. So, dear brothers and sisters, to conclude, pray this week for the Church, as you pray for yourselves. Pray for the Diocese of Lancaster, of which we're a part here. Pray for vocations. But also broaden your prayer. Pray for the world, for peace and harmony in the world. We're very conscious of what took place in Manchester, the horror of it all last Monday evening. Let your prayer embrace all those in any way affected. And so today, finally, the Lord assured us that he would not leave his orphans. What a lovely thought, but that he would come to us, and he comes to us through the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. So may the week ahead, as we begin with this Mass, be a fruitful one for all of us, and may we be renewed and refreshed by the gentle breeze of God's Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. and resurrects the Tertia Dei Secundum Sculpturas, et Ascendem in Caelum, sede ad dextra in Patris, in iterum venturus est cum gloria, unicari vivos et mortuos, cuius regni non erat finis. Et in spiritu sanctum dominum in vivi vicante, et ex patri filioque proceded, qui cum patri et filio simula curata et cum glorificata, qui locutus est per profetas, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confitiorum baptisma in remissionum peccatorum, et expectio resurrectionum mortuorum, et vitam venturi saeculi. Sersum Corum. Gratia Seamus Domine Deum.
Dignum et Justum Est.
Veri dignum et Justum Est, equum et salutare, os tibi semper et ubique gratias angeli, Domine Sancti, Patro Omnipotens Eterni Deus, per Christum Domine Nostrum. Post-resurrection, suam omnipostitione suis manifestus apparat, et ipsis trinitibus est elevatus in cielo, ut nos divinitatis sui tribuerit esse participes. Et ideum cum angelis et archangelis, confrones et dominationibus cumque omnem omnescia celestis exercitus, hymnum gloriae tuae canimus, sine
Thank you.
peremptoribus nostris, et labos in casa contentatio.
Thank you. and angels of angels, subject to men, subject to difficulties and love of men and women. Dominions and demons of angels, subject to men, subject to difficulties and love of men and women. Dominions and demons of angels, subject to men, subject to difficulties and love of men and women.
Thank you. Our hope is in you. Oh,